the Proud Boys, or people who consider them to be members of this group, give voice to these misogynistic, Islamophobic, anti-Semitic, anti-immigrant views. They're a despicable group by pretty much anyone's standards. So when the president was asked about them, and you say he denounced them, that's what you're insisting that he did on the debate stage the other night. If that's the case, then why are they celebrating what the president said on the debate stage in front of millions of people?
Well, I don't speak for that group, so I'm not sure why you're asking me why they're saying a certain thing.
If someone denounced you, you probably wouldn't put it on a T-shirt and make badges of it, right?
The president did denounce them. He was asked, will you tell them to stand down? He said, sure. He went on to stand by,
which seems like an instruction.
He said, stand back. And then just yesterday when he was asked, he said specifically, stand down, a synonym with stand back. And the president said, sure, when asked by the moderator whether they should stand down. It's really interesting, too, to see that the media seems to be the only one putting the names of these groups into headlines, into media reporting. He didn't know who the Proud Boys were. First time I heard of them was in the debate, but the media continues to put these names into circulation and give them a lot of public attention.
He was given about 12 hours, more than that, since from the debate, from when he was asked to clarify yesterday. And he didn't come out and clarify yesterday. Instead, he did what you did when John asked you to unambiguously denounce these groups. You just pointed to past things that you've said. I just don't understand why you knew you were going to get these questions and you don't have a statement ready to just say, we do unambiguously denounce these groups.
Caitlin,
do
you know why people have lost trust in the media? There was a reporter from your network yesterday, and in a tweet said, quote,
I'm asking you a question.
I sat here when you lobbed your partisan attack question, so you will allow me to give an answer. The president and someone from your network said yesterday in a tweet, the president dodged a question about white supremacy. That was a tweet from a CNN reporter. The president specifically, verbatim, was asked yesterday, white supremacy, do you denounce them? To which he responded, I have always denounced any form of that. Those are the facts. And CNN, I know that truth is of no moment to your network, but those are the facts.
They're not the facts. Why are Republicans are calling on the president to be more forceful? His own party.
Thanks, Kayleigh. I had a question about unemployment, but I first wanted to clean up something from your opening. You said Judge Barrett was a Rhodes Scholar. I'm not sure that that's true.
That's what I have written here.
She attended Rhodes College.
So my bad.
Very different thing.
Yes.
All right. Anyway, within the last...